Did you know that if your site takes more than 2 seconds to load, around 47% of the visitors will leave without waiting? Just imagine, 2 seconds, I mean 2 seconds, isn't enough to do anything really. Even reaching out for that cup on your desk and taking a sip of hot coffee will take longer. Yet somehow, those same 2 seconds are still more than what 47% of people on the internet are willing to wait for a site to load. This is scary, if you ask me. As a site owner, I really am scared knowing this piece of statistic. But wait, there's more. More bad news that is. Google now admits that site speed is an important ranking factor. In plain English, if your site takes a long while to load, it will drop from the rankings or never earn any rankings in the first place. This is where the video you're watching right now comes into play. In the coming minutes, I will show you some easy fixes to make your site faster and thus cater better your audience and make Google happy at the same time. These are the things you can do on your WordPress site to improve the loading time significantly. You don't need any coding or technical skills to do this. It will cut your loading time in half or more. You will see the results right away, and it's all free, no investments required. Let's get on with it. WordPress plugins are like a drug, in a way that installing the next one is hard to resist. It's worth keeping in mind, though, that each plugin you install is going to contribute to your site's overall loading time. In other words, the more plugins you have, the slower your site gets. Over 80% of the entire load time is due to plugins. How to fix this? Go to your installed plugins and simply remove everything that is non-crucial. Remove everything that your site can live without. This step alone can cut your loading time in half. You can remove the default plugins each new WordPress install comes with. For example, you know the Hello Dolly plugin. You can uninstall and delete that plugin for sure. Well, if you are not sure what the plugin is for, just deactivate it and check if something is missing. If not, you can delete that plugin too. If you are still unsure what that plugin does on your site, you can keep it deactivated until you will be sure it's useless. You will know that over time, and if you keep it deactivated, it will no longer influence the loading time of your WordPress website. Removing the plugins that you don't use is step number one. Step two is removing the plugins that are too slow and finding quicker alternatives to them. How to find out which plugins are slow? Generally, there are 5 types of plugins that affect your website's performance heavily: security plugins, backup plugins, contact forms, SEO plugins, and e-commerce. The chances are that you are going to improve your site speed significantly just by searching for more efficient versions of any of those plugins. Well, I think it's hard to find an alternative for e-commerce where every one of us uses the so popular WooCommerce plugin, right? But for other functionalities, I think it's worth making a thorough research. Okay, caching is a fairly complex and fairly boring topic, so let's not get into the specifics. The only thing we do need to know at this stage is that caching helps your server out by putting some of the load off the WordPress software, and thus allowing for your website to be delivered quicker. Caching does wonder. It's capable of speeding up your site from 2.4 seconds of load time to 0.9 seconds, for example. And the best part? Even though it's a technical thing, it's enabled through an easy-to-grasp plugin. The plugin is called WT Total Cache. Just install and activate it normally. Now, the plugin has a lot of options and possible customizations. However, right after activation, it begins working on its default settings with no input required on your part. So, if you don't want to play with the settings on your own, just activate the plugin, forget it, and let it work on autopilot. Optimize and database sound like intimidating words, but they are not, at least not in this case. What I mean here is making your WordPress site quicker by optimizing its database via, you guessed it, a plugin. It's called WP Optimize. Again, install and activate normally, and then let it optimize your database on autopilot. The thing with WordPress plugins is that they only slow your site down when they are active. Now, the trick is that not all plugins need to be active all the time. Some of them, for example, only need to stay active for a couple of minutes every week, so they can do their job and then you can deactivate them again. Such plugins are plugins for optimizing your database. The plugin mentioned above, for example, only needs to be activated once a month or so. Let it do its job and then just turn it off. Broken links checkers, if you use those. Content optimization plugins and social media trackers. One more example I have in my mind right now is the plugin you use for backing up your WordPress website manually. Well, if that plugin is set to do the work automatically, you need to keep it active, though. Pingbacks and Trackbacks are two core WordPress components that alert you whenever your blog or page receives a link. It might sound useful, but you also have things such as Google Webmaster Tools and other services to check the links for you. Keeping pingbacks and trackbacks on can also put an undesirable amount of strain on your server resources. This is so because whenever anyone tries to link up your site, it generates requests from WordPress back and forth. This functionality is also widely abused when targeting a website with DDoS attacks. You can turn it all off in Settings, Discussion. Just deselect Allow Link Notifications from Other Blogs, Pingbacks and Trackbacks. This will help you speed up WordPress some more. Okay, that's it for this video. Feel free to let me know how the optimizations have gone for you and what sort of improvement you've managed to get. The next part is all about the number one thing that slows your site down. Care to guess what that might be? And most importantly, how to save yourself from trouble? Please make sure to subscribe so the next video we publish gets delivered to your inbox with no issues, and click the bell for notifications. Leave a comment below if you have any questions, and I will do my best to answer them. See you in the next video.